guys. All right, so first items I'm gonna start off with is quite a few Sally Beauty stuff. And I just want to get some more things from the Sally Girl collection. I'm trying to get into it. It's really affordable. And a lot of people do compliment that line and say how great some of their stuff is. So I wanted to branch out a little bit more. I only have one eyeshadow and two little mini lip glosses from them. Please let me know what you guys think of them. I like them. I like what I have so far. But yeah, so let me go ahead and show you what I got. I got a Sally Girl Brow Powder in Ebony. I got another eyeshadow. I don't think they name their eyeshadows. I could be wrong, but yeah, they don't name their eyeshadows. But the number is 388123. And let's see. Pick up some color for you. And these are their baked eyeshadows for 99 cents. And there we go. I hope it translates well on my eye. It's a little rough from what I could tell, but we'll see how it works later on. Let's see what else I can show you guys from there. I got these glitters, and they're just like loose glitters. You can't use them on your eyes, I read. So I was thinking maybe I could try to work them out like with something like mix them with some perfume, like some body spray, so I can get some shimmer on my skin with these. Because they look like they're pretty fine, like as far as the particles go. I'm not 100% sure if all of these are going to be able to be usable for body sprays. But yeah, I just figured I'd try them and see how they would work. Again, these are, I don't know if I said that already, but these are 99 cents. Pretty much, I think their whole line is 99 cents, but don't quote me on that. And that's it for Sally Beauty. And then, put that flower down. The next things that I want to show you, I went kind of crazy lately at the Dollar Tree. They've been having some pretty amazing things there to pick up. So I got a whole lot of stuff from the Dollar Tree. So I'll be right back. All right, guys. So I'm going to go ahead and continue with the Family Dollar items. Now, the Family Dollar items I'm going to have swatched on my blog. I have my blog link below. Or I just learned how to use annotations or whatever you call them. So I maybe put the link in the video just to play around and see how it works out. We'll see. But anyways, you can check out on my link the swatches for these items. So I'm going to go ahead and... All right, guys. So this is going to be the Dollar Tree part. So let me go ahead and get started and show you some of the items that I have right here. I have this awesome mirror. It's a cosmetic mirror with a stand. This is the stand. So you can hang it up on your wall like this, or you could place it like this, and it's really neat, and it's 4 by 6 inches, so that's a really good size, I think. And yeah, that's pretty much it. That's the mirror. Then I got some e.l.f. Studio Line eyeshadows, and I got it in, let's see, I got some in Wild Wheat, Saddle, Buttercream, which I wore the other day. And it is really a good shade. And Mystic Moss, which is another good shade. There it is right there. And the only problem, I just want to say that with the Dollar Tree eyeshadows and stuff, you just want to make sure that no one has opened them and swatched them. Because I am very detail-oriented, and I always look at everything before I purchase it. And I've been noticing lately that a lot of the eyeshadows, especially the e.l.f. ones, especially the Studio Line ones there, are being opened and swatched, and that basically does not allow me to purchase it. So one, stop opening and swatching them. If you want to know what color it is, just buy it. It's only $1. And two, at least if you swatch it, leave it out of the package so that everyone knows they can swatch it themselves, so they can know, instead of opening another one. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So anyways, also got this e.l.f. all over color stick, and this is in Golden Peach. Oh, I should show you guys so you can see. And I'll swatch all of this stuff for you guys on my blog, okay? And then I kind of went nuts and got I got three of these Almay One Coat Dial-Up mascaras. I got two in Blackest of Black, and I'll have more detailed pictures of these, you know, on the blog. And then I got the black brown one. And I thought this was a really good deal because I know that these, at least in Walgreens, I saw these for like, I think $8.49 or something like that. So I think this is a really good find. So definitely visit your local Dollar Tree. And let's move on. Let me show you what else I got here. Let's see. I got this, another Sally Hansen's Healing Butter Shimmer for your lips. And I got it in Impulse. And this was originally priced at Walgreens for $5.99. Look, it has the price tag on it still. So, yeah. Great discount. And then I got another one. And I got that one in Bliss. And I'm kind of glad that they left the price tag on so that, you know, you can see that how much originally they were charging for it. And now you get it for a dollar. So that's pretty neat. And, yeah, this is the Bliss shade. And I absolutely love these. These are going to be great for the wintertime, you guys. You guys got to pick some of these up. These are absolutely awesome. Love them. So, next thing I got, which I normally don't even bother with these, are these L'Oreal lip colors. I got it in Captivating Coral because I'm kind of getting into coral. I'm not really a fan of it. I kind of think of it as a grandma color. Ugh, please don't hate me, guys, for saying that, but I don't know, coral's just not a shade that I think is flattering for most people. But I know there's different ranges of coral and things like that, but I just think of it as like a grandma color, and that's not offensive or anything. I just think it's more for older woman who needs something that's a warmer, brighter color, as opposed for a younger woman who can have a wider range of colors. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. Yeah, so that's just my opinion on it. But I wanted to try this because this color really spoke out to me. And I thought this was a really nice shade. Oh, I don't want to lose the sticker. Hold on. The sticker is stuck to the bottom of the packaging. Of the outside of the packaging, I mean. Alright, so this is the shade right here. And I think this is the richest coral I've ever seen. I definitely hope that it does go well with my skin. If not, it'll just be one of those things that, you know, you live and learn, you know. But, yeah, so that's that. Let's see what else. I got these. I went kind of crazy with these too. I don't know why I did that. But I got a whole bunch of these lip palettes by Jane from there. And I got it in Brocade. I don't know how to say that. Taffeta and Satin. And I think these are really good for the price. Even if it wasn't a dollar, I still think these are really good. They are fairly pigmented. They do apply pretty sheer, but like I said, for the quality, I think they're really good. And quantity, maybe not so much. I mean, you get 0.20 ounces. I guess that's pretty standard. But I do like the range of them. I think they're really pretty. And if you open up the back side of them, you get a lip brush with it. And it's actually a pretty decent lip brush and a mirror, just in case you didn't see that. And yeah, so I'll have the swatches for that. You know where. And then I got a Revlon eyeshadow, a matte one, and it's in Luscious Lime. Open it up for you guys. This is shade right there. And I just got it because it was a really light green color. Kind of reminds me of the NARS color, I believe, from their, like, I think the palette is called Wicked. It's like the two dual palette. I just don't remember the name of that shade, but yeah, it's kind of like a, it's not a dupe, this is way chalkier, but it just kind of reminded me of it. It's a nice color. And then, let's see, I picked up this Maybelline Express Makeup Face and Body, and it's in Mauvey Gold, and it's supposed to be, I guess you can use this basically for a highlight. If you want to highlight like this part of your face with a nice golden shimmer to it. Get quite a bit of product with it. Stinks. Ugh, stinks really bad actually, but we'll see if it works. I'll test this sucker out. But it's, gosh, this does smell horrible. Ugh. Alright. Next, I got this Lusty Organics Olive Oil Hair Sheen, and this is to rejuvenate fragile. Alright guys, sorry, my camera stopped recording, but anyways, I was talking about this olive oil hair sheen right here, and the reason that I got it, I've never tried it before, but it supposedly, it conditions dry, brittle, chemically treated colored hair, and I've bleached my hair, dyed my hair, did chop it off myself, you know, So I'm looking for something to kind of rejuvenate it. It was only $1. It smells really good. Well, it doesn't smell really good. It smells pretty decent, though. So I figured, why not try it? And I was reading the ingredients. It has a lot of, I don't want to say organic ingredients, because, I mean, I really don't know for sure if it's really organic. Just because it says it's organic doesn't mean it is. But it has a lot of, like, flower extracts in it. So it might prove to be really worth trying. So I just figured I'd show you guys this just in case you guys wanted to try this as well. And then, oh my god, guys, I love these. You have to go out and get these. If you don't want any of the makeup or anything that I'm showing you, you guys gotta try these. These smell amazing. These are the Healing Garden, these are the Healing Garden body scrubs. I have this one in Inspire, and it's an uplifting jasmine black rice scrub. And oh my god, does it smell amazing. And then I have another one, and it's Passionate Rose sugarcane body scrub. The other one was black rice. This one is sugarcane, and it's called Romance. And this one, oh my god, they had so many. I was about to take all of them. They had like I think 5 different scents, and I only got 2 because I didn't see the other 3. But yeah, I didn't want to get crazy because I already brought too much. But yeah, you guys gotta try these. If anything, I love body scrubs, and I cannot wait to try these. And then last but not least, I got a little thing of grease. Because since the weather is getting colder, my hair does get drier. And I do use grease for my hair to moisturize it and get it shiny and, you know, manageable. So that's pretty much it for this haul. Sorry it kept cutting out and everything. Hope it wasn't too long. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.